So I am Dr. Mark Allen Fye. I've been practicing spinal surgery in Pittsburgh since 1996. I actually tend to do less surgery now than I did 15 years ago because my experience in following patients, I can see now what happens long-term with most of these patients with spinal problems that end up having surgery. So what is spinal stenosis? Spinal stenosis, true definition, means narrowing. So you have an area in your canal where the nerves go through, whether it's your cervical spine or your lumbar spine. And when that area gets narrowed, going from the size of a quarter to a pencil, that's what we call spinal stenosis. So the causes of spinal stenosis are basically two things. One is the joints in your back, called the facets, get arthritic. Just like your knee and hip can get arthritic, the bone spurs develop around those joints to stabilize the joint. Unfortunately, those bone spurs can go into the canal and cause a narrowing where the nerves are. So the bone spurs, in essence, are pinching the nerve, causing that sciatica that we typically see in patients with leg pain. There's basically three things that happen. One, you can have up and down where you get better, you get worse. The other option that happens is, unfortunately, people progress. So spinal stenosis can, unfortunately, cause leg pain, leg numbness, leg weakness, and for about a third of the patients, that will progress. So last year, they can maybe walk a mile. The next year, they walk a half mile, and now they're only walking a quarter of a mile or less. And sometimes patients can't walk more than 10 feet. So the progression is what I see in one third of the patients. Most patients in another third will have a plateau of symptoms where they can basically live with them. And there are patients that have the up and down cycle where a couple months they might get aggravated and it gets better. And again, it goes back to getting worse again. The patients I see typically in the office are the ones that are progressing and getting worse and can't live with their symptoms. There's three basic things that happen when a nerve gets irritated or pinched. You have pain, typically is the first thing people experience. With that pain, you can be associated with numbness or tingling in your hands or your feet, and you can have numbness tingling down your leg as well. And finally, if it is progressive, you can have weakness in your muscles within your lower extremity or your upper extremity. So the treatments we generally prescribe for spinal stenosis usually is a cardiovascular fitness program with or without physical therapy. Occasionally, someone would get an epidural steroid injection, which is putting steroid around the nerves. And finally, it's surgical options when they have progression of their pain, numbness, or weakness. So I'm frequently asked if there's a cure to spinal stenosis. If that patient has progression and there's pain, numbness, and weakness in their lower extremities or their upper extremities for cervical stenosis, typically surgery will cure that. Well, generally, 80% of patients come back very happy. 1 out of 10 patients usually come back and feel that their pain is stopped, but isn't getting a lot better. But in that one last patient out of 10, typically I've helped them in a way that they don't get worse in the future. So I would tell you the vast majority of patients get better if you pick your patients properly. What's the most important thing is trying to communicate with your patient, understanding their problem, and then correlating that with their imaging. And I think that those patients that have leg pain, not back pain, but leg pain or leg issues like numbness or weakness, typically if that progresses, surgery can very much cure that problem. So what happens if you have progressive weakness and surgery is not done? I do think there's the urgent case where patients have true weakness of their muscle groups and they should have an operation if the imaging correlates with what I think is causing their problem. Surgery is very helpful. If you don't have surgery and you're progressing, then unfortunately that nerve can be damaged. It's very controversial at what point does a nerve become damaged where it's irreversible for surgery. And we generally use 6 months as a general rule for most of us in the spine world doing surgery. If you have progression over 6 months, I think it's important to have an evaluation. And for most people that have progression and they have imaging that correlates, surgery is the best option. If you don't, then you unfortunately sometimes have profound weakness that doesn't get better. So when you're looking for a physician to take care of your problem with spinal stenosis, there's two types of surgeons that are qualified to see someone for surgical opinion. One is an orthopedic spine surgeon and the other is a neurosurgeon. Fortunately for today, both of those surgeons can take care of someone very well with spinal stenosis. In the past, orthopedic spine surgeons did a lot of the instrumentation. Now you can have well-trained neurosurgeons as well take care of that. So if you're looking for someone to take care of your problem with spinal stenosis, either one is an option for you. And I really enjoy trying to get to know my patients. And unfortunately in today's world of medicine, specifically surgery, sometimes we lose that art. The best part, in my opinion, I tell my children all the time, is that patient comes back and gives me a hug.